Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about the applications of percent problems or percent applications. The first one we're going to talk about is a word problem that says the max resistance of a workout machine is 86% of a person's body weight. What would be the max resistance of a 175-pound man? So the max resistance you could get on this machine if the person was 175 pounds. So what we want to do is set up a percent proportion, which we talked about in another video. And so I'm interested in the amount over the base and the percent over 100. So what do I know here? Well, I know 100 for sure. And then I look for the number with the percent symbol on it. I have one. It's 86%. Sometimes I'd have to do this a little differently. We'll see. But in this case, I'm just talking about 86% of somebody's max body weight. So the base is the original total. And so in this case, it's the original total of the person working out. That's 175. And we want to know then the amount. We want to know how much resistance could we get if we had a 175-pound person, knowing that the max you can get is 86% of their body weight. To solve that, I would cross multiply. That's going to be 86 times 175. I don't know what that is. I have no problem with using my calculator because there's no point in doing all that calculation out on paper. 15,050, my calculator gave me. Multiplying the other way, I have 100 times A that I can do. And then I'm going to divide both sides by 100. Now, I know that 100 is a power of 10. And I know over here these 100s are going to go away. But when I divide by a power of 10, I just move the decimal point two places to the left. When it's 100, I should say, because there's two zeros. So I just go back two. I know that's going to be the answer. If you don't know that, then you can just use your calculator, and you're going to get 150.5, which is exactly what we would have got if we just would have moved that back two places. So I'm going to say 150.5 is A. When you're talking about something like that, if you wrote A equals 150.5, that would be fine as well. On Math Excel, which we use a lot, if you enter your answer, they sometimes already have this part, A equals, and all they want you to answer is, all they want you to put in is the answer. So be careful and see what they actually want. Okay, second one, a student spent $1,890 on tuition and fees. If she spent $210 on fees, what percent did she spend on fees? Round to the nearest tenth. So we again want amount over base is percent over 100. We want to find something with a percent symbol on it. We don't see it. What percent did she spend? That's what they're asking us. So we don't know percent here. Okay, what was the total that she spent? The original total was 1,890, and we know that she spent 210 of that on fees. So we want to put the 210 as the amount that we're interested here. And now we're going to cross multiply, and these I can do without a calculator. I know that I have 1,890p when I multiply those two, and when I multiply 210 times 100, I just have to add two zeros, but feel free to use your calculator if that would make you more comfortable. And then we're going to divide both sides by 1890, and it says round to the tenth. So let's see what we get here. 21,000 is divided by 1,890, and that gives us 11.111111. So what did that, would that be rounded? Well, rounded to the nearest tenth would just be 0.1 or 1/10. So that would be P equals 11.1. And that's my percent. So it would be 11.1% of her money went to fees. That sounds about reasonable. Okay, this one's a little different. Find the population decrease. If the town went from a population of 12,000 to 9,750. And I really should have said when I wrote this problem, find the percentage of the population decrease. But you're going to see that there's no percentage given. So that's what we're looking for. I think this is kind of a, not the greatest problem I ever wrote in my life, I'm going to say. But anyway, let's answer it anyway. I want to find out what the percent was of decrease. Now, This is a little tricky because if I just put the numbers in that I was given, well, let's do that. So you can see it went from 12,000 down to 9,750. And let's just do it that way. The original total was 12,000. Of course, I know the 100. I don't know the percent. That's what I'm looking for. And then I went down to 9,750. If I cross multiply here, I get 12,000p, and I cross multiply the other way, I get 9,750 and two more zeros, right? That's easy to do when you're dividing by or multiplying by a power of 10 like that. So I'm going to divide both sides by the coefficient, which is 12,000. And I don't know what that is, so let's do that. I know the 12,000s will cancel, so that's good. And I know that then my new percentage is going to be 975,000. When you enter that, you might want to say it just like I did to make sure you don't leave a zero off. Divided by 12,000, three zeros there, and I get 81.25. Now, here's the mistake that people make. They go, okay, final answer, it dropped by 81.25. Think for a second. If your population was 12,000 and it dropped by 50% or half your people left, you'd be down to 6,000, right? But you're not down that far. You haven't lost even half of your people. So what is this answer? This answer is the people that are still there. So what you have to do is say, I used to have 100%. Let me take away the 81.25% that are still there, and that's going to tell me what the decrease was. So I know I would take 100 minus 81.25, and that would tell me, oh, I had a decrease of 18.75. That's tricky. So what I suggest you do instead is right from the beginning say, oh, I'm looking for the decrease. Let me take the 12,000 that I started with and subtract the people that are still there. That is 12,000 minus 9,750 and see how many people are left. Well, there's 2,250 people left. So when you work this problem, it'd be better to say 2,250 out of 12,000, because these are the people that left. That's your decrease. And then do that, and you're going to get 12,000p equals 225,000, divide by the coefficient, and what do you get? Well, you get p over here, right? And on the other side, 225,000 divided by 12 with three zeros is 18.75. Wait a second, that's the same thing we got over here. So yes, there are two ways to get the same thing. One, we use the original numbers given, but we had to recognize that's not the decrease, that's the people that are left. That's what we still have. What we lost was that number from 100. The other way, we said, well, we want the decrease, so let's just find out how many people left in the beginning. 2,250 people left, so that's what I'm going to put up there for my amount, and that's going to give me directly the decrease in the population percentage-wise that we saw.